As actions speak louder than words, Tanzania continues to fight its war against poaching. It also looks to its citizens to chip in and pursue different careers in the wildlife sector. As I continue to be curious in Tanzania, while traveling back to the restaurant, I had an opportunity to meet a new friend, a young pilot. He was able to share his story with us. This is his story.
Meet Suleiman, one of the few young professionals who is currently pursuing pilot studies in South Africa and also studied in the US.
What inspired you to becoming a pilot, and why in Tanzania?
It started as a dream when I was very young. But being a part of Tanzanian society, it was not easy for me to achieve my dreams as big as I wanted it.
Okay.
So soon after I completed my A level, I had to go for another course that was diploma in wildlife management.
Okay.
And when I was in my second year, I had a very impressive result.
Okay.
And I was then chosen to join Swanee University in South Africa.
Okay.
For my bachelor. So when I was in the third year, I discussed with my parents that I have a call that I wanted to be a pilot.
What does your family think about you becoming a pilot and achievements?
My father was very interested with the idea, and he supported us. We were two of us.
Okay.
We were two boys in our family, and we were all pilots. Unfortunately, I lost my brother.
Oh, wow.
And I was doing my first, it was just after my first license.
Okay.
And it was a bit discouraging because my brother crashed. And I was in America for my commercial.
Okay.
I came back for his burial ceremony. And when we completed it,
okay,
I had a very difficult time thinking that I have to go back and do the same thing. My father kept on encouraging me, but my mother was a bit worried. You know, mothers,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. Mothers, yeah.
Yeah, but after a month or so, I told them I want to go back and pursue my commercial.
Okay.
And I explained that, see, me and my brother, we are thinking one day probably two brothers will be flying a Boeing internationally.
Okay.
And that was a dream and a plan. After I lost my brother, it was like everything coming back to zero.
Okay.
Thinking that I have to struggle by myself. But because I had that call, that I wanted to be a pilot but nothing else, then I had the courage to go back and finish up my training.
Okay.
And then I came back, and here I am now.
How is it working with the Minister of Tourism and flying him everywhere?
Okay, that to me is like an opportunity. I'm very proud of it. He's a very generous man.
Yes.
And being exposed to him in so many areas and so many activities where he works, we are learning a lot.
Okay.
Because he's very smart, he's young, and we created that special force of young people.
Okay.
That we could work together to make sure that the minister meets his goals.
Okay.
On time, and since he's very busy, we have to make sure that we squeeze ourselves into his timetable and make sure that his duties are performed the highest degree.
Okay. What kind of like future projects are you guys, is the minister and you guys working on?
Yeah, the minister has been trying to pull a lot of donors to support conservation.
Okay.
And through all that, we have been, some donors have donated helicopters, and he's working toward it to give us an opportunity to go and train on a helicopter.
Okay.
So that's another big thing to me, because there's very few pilots in this world that can fly fixed wing as well as helicopters.
Okay.
And I love conservation.
Yeah.
So to me, these helicopters, I'm looking forward to protect conservation, especially okay. elephant.
Okay.
So these are the future plans.
Oh, wow. Wow. What do your friends think about you and being a pilot? Do they think like you're cool, or they think you like, how do they think about you?
Okay. I keep a very close contact with my friends, and they think I'm cool, because when I'm off duty, we have time to discuss.
Okay.
I cope with almost everybody, trying to maintain my discipline as much as I can.
Okay.
And protect my dignity. But in some cases, since we are very busy,
okay.
For some people, they might think that you do not have so much time to spend
with them.
But some friends understand, and they encourage me.
Okay.
They think I'm very courageous. And yeah.
So, you are 28 right now. Where do you see yourself at maybe like 40?
Okay. I have a dream to go to the airliners. Aviation is something that is kindly divided into patches as you grow to become professional,
okay.
or as you go to the airline.
Okay.
When you finish up school, you have a long way to build your hours and get experience. Because in aviation we say every landing is different. So if you have done 10,000 landings, every single landing was different from the other.
Yeah.
And everybody can fly, but not everybody can land.
Okay.
So it's a learning process. Through this process, I target myself to go to the airline before early 30s.
Oh, wow.
And probably in the future, I would like to fly the bigger airlines like Emirates and Qatar.
What about Air Tanzania if it comes back? It's back already.
Yeah, Air Tanzania is getting on track.
Okay.
We very much appreciate, and the government is working on it. It will be very nice for me to fly the national flag. I'm looking forward for that. So definitely, if I get an opportunity to train Air Tanzania,
yeah,
I'll be very proud.
Wow. Okay, so you just heard from a young pilot from Tanzania. Tanzania has so many talented people. As you probably know, Tanzania's population, if you look at it, is most of us are under the age of 30, which is almost like 50% of Tanzania's population is under the age of 30. So I'm trying to find out what different Tanzanians, different young people, what are they doing? What are they doing in Tanzania? And to just bring it out to you guys, and so you can know what we all about, what we up to, and you can be able to support us at the same time.